Hi guys. As you can see, I'm over in the workshop. It's dark. It's pissing it down with rain. I've got these couple of boxes here I need to put in the car. Because I have to try and make something up to put that record player in. Want that. Right. Yeah, we've been busy. We were supposed to go and get some more stuff today, but we didn't. We decided not to. Take that back with me. It's actually working pretty well. Just, that's not mine. Right. So, aside from a tube for that light, we're good. We've got sockets to put at that end, which I'm just going to use a trailing socket thing, which I've got here. Just use that. That one right on the top there will screw straight to the wall up here somewhere. And I'll just run the cable straight to that. Wire it straight in. So it's permanently wired. All the clamps, all the screwdrivers, everything is sorted. He's even got his stool in here. As you can see, it's still quite dark, so he's still going to need a light above his workbench at least. But everything is pretty much sorted, all in place. We've still got a handful of bits bring over. I thought I might as well stick the camera on just before I run those bits to the car. It's actually quite a good battery. Okay. Might have to do one box at a time, I think. I sat and done all those, so if they're not up there's level, that's my fault. And I did those. Got the 9mm missing. I've got one at home I can hang on there, that's not a problem. I've got shed loads of spanners at home, I'm sure I can find a 9 up to hang on there. I think that was a train that just went rumbling past. Here. It's not actually cold out here, to be honest. I'm quite comfortable in just my coat. Right. We also emptied the shed in the corner of the garden as well. Well, most of it. We've just got the boxes of books to move. Joy, they're going to be fucking heavy. Not looking forward to that one. Weird noises going on out there. Done. I think that's a great deal I get now. Right, so on that note, I'm going to shut down and I'll talk to you again when I get home. Home again, jiggity jig. We are back home. Hi, Nemo. I'm going to throw out this Christmas tree because I don't need it, so I grabbed that, so I've got a replacement for next year. Don't know where I'm going to stick that yet. This will probably be a Gumtree item later. Excuse me. Got a couple of other bits for that. I don't know why, but whenever I'm sitting here at the computer with the camera on, that's where Nemo sits. Don't you? Anyway, he wants food, I want a drink, so we'll just go into the kitchen. I'll flick some lights on. I'll move that box out of the way for a minute. One day I will clean this shit tip up. Stupid camera, all it's got to do is sit flat. Right. There we go. Drink for me, that's what I want. One drink. One, I'm thirsty. Two, I've got to take my pill. Yeah, no, I shouldn't take pills on Coca-Cola, but it's not done me any harm for the past 3 years, so. Half the time I wonder if the medical profession just do it just to be whinge bags. You shouldn't do that. What I shouldn't do and what I do are two different things. And I nearly got that one stuck in my throat. So that'll serve me right, won't it? Ooh. Right. Tomorrow I think we're going to get... try to get as much of the last lot as we can from the house. I've got to go and pick up a parcel from the post office. All that time, the postman was leaving parcels at my door, just outside on the floor. And Saturday, when I wasn't here, he decides to post this through my letterbox. But as Mum said, it's most likely a different postman, so... still annoying. Because I could have had my track, and I could have had all that complete. Yeah. No, I can't do it until tomorrow, even when I get the track. Well, it's been raining. And, obviously my stepdad said, if it's still raining in the morning, we won't be doing anything. Yeah, it's been on charge all day, and those red lights still haven't... I need to find, one, my other multimeter, and two, the probes for it. I've got to get some new probes for this one. My stepdad's got broken, and actually so did one of mine, so I gave him, and one of his got lost, so I gave him mine, because my meter wasn't working that well at the time. And for £2.22, I can get some probes that will fit that thing, so that'll do. I don't know where my other meter is. I've got my analogue one up here, but the probes won't fit. But I've got another set of test leads with crocodile clips on that I can use for the time being, which I would use just to test this battery, just to see if this damn thing is actually charging. But I don't know where either of them are. well, I'll just have to test that as and when I find them. Well, I found one. USB cable. I was looking in here if I could see anything else that resembles a cable. Nope. I've got to roll them up. Actually, I'm pretty certain one fell on the floor down here somewhere, so I may have thrown it on one of these shelves. And if memory serves correctly, it was the black one. Ah, here's the red one. So I've got the red one. It is the black one I'm after. Well, that, which is my continuity tester. Even though my multimeter does the same thing, but both my multimeters do the same thing, actually. Where does the other test probe have to be? The black one that's missing. I do hate trying to find black. Where's my flashlight? I swear it was down here. I swear I dropped it. And the chances are I've picked it up and possibly laid it up here somewhere. Nope. I need one more epoxy. Ah, there it is. Hey, found it. I knew it was down there somewhere. Yeah, should we give you a different view of the room? I'll put you up there for a minute. While I plug in my leads, right. Black goes into comm. Ouch. Red goes into the next one, like a saw. Turn it to 20 volts, said DC. I was trying to measure AC with DC, or measure AC voltage with DC setting yesterday. That wasn't working, and I couldn't. It took me to about 2 or 3 minutes to try and, you know, to figure out why the multimeter wasn't reading the voltage, and then I realised. I'm just going to make sure the charge is outputting a voltage at 13 point some odd volts. So, what about our battery? It is charging. It started life around about the 5 volt mark, and we now have, I don't know if I can I clip these on there? Yeah, just to show you. We now have 11 odd volts on there. So that's good. It is charging, at least. It is charging. It's taking a long time. But I actually find that the flatter a battery is, the longer it takes to charge. I actually left this on charge while I wasn't here, and I don't like doing that, but I guess I forgot to turn it off. Alright. I've actually got a choice. I could either go out and buy another one of these, which is a bit pointless, because I've got two that work. I've managed to get that one to work. The screen went all funny on this one. And all it was what they call it a zebra strip. And it's basically like a piece of rubber with a conductive strip down the middle, and that's used to connect the screen to the circuit board. That had just slipped out of place. So, that won't work. But, for the sake of £2.22, I could actually get a set of probes for each. Not that I would actually need to, because, I could leave the crocodile clips in one and the pointy probes in another one. I don't know. I'll have a look on eBay in a little while. Anyway, like I said, this is going on Gumtree. This, I might eBay. The Goodyear Bridge. I've got a couple of days before I can list anything on eBay again. Well, I could, but it would go for stupid amounts of, you know, silly money, not for what it's worth, because, that's the risk I'd be taking if I listed them now. What have I got in here? Oh, I've got my cordless. Might want that tomorrow. Those batteries have done well. The other one wants a charge. I'm going to have to empty that in. I've got a free pen as well, from the look of it. Tell you what, I was making sure I weren't covering up the microphone. I was going to put you up here, and I'll bring the box into the light. Showing it yet as well. Hopefully I can get the box in that little gap. Right, I'm ready. Here we go. Random tools. What we got? Oh yeah. Oh, that seems to have disappeared. Well, it might still be in the back of the car, actually. I believe I laid these in the back of the car. Should be a big Red Britain's trailer somewhere. I don't think I'll eBay that. I don't think it's worth anything. But got an amp meter. Apparently it came off a boat. But, So do I put my live on there and ground it out on one of these? Is that how that works? I don't know. Let's do another battery to my drill. It's still charged. I was still able to put screws in with that. It was just a bit slow. Got a couple of gas bottle regulators. Stepdad said I could put on eBay. So that's what I'm going to do with those. I don't know when, but they will go on eBay at some point. There is just there's a couple of kettle leads and whatnot in the bottom here, but the rest is just random tools. Some of them were already mine, like those. But it's just a few tools. Look, a chisely thing in there. Files. I haven't got any files. I was working on a bike recently where I could have actually done with a file, so stepdad was going to get rid of these, so I grabbed some files. There's a few random screwdrivers in here as well. A few other random bits. There's a bike spanner in the bottom here. There's another head torch. It's two of these I've got. Now, does it still work? Batteries have gone dead. I'll have to flick that cover off and take them out before they start leaking. Yeah, a random power adapter as well. There's it. Bought that home yesterday. Bought that one home yesterday. I've got a big one of these batteries. It's actually a car battery that I'm going to bring home because it is a good battery. And I could use that as... I'd probably use that one as a spare. For the shed. Like I said, I bought this green one home because I don't actually know if that green one's going to work. These... This one doesn't actually hold a charge very well. Don't know. This, I'm going to take this one apart, and I've got another one that I've got to take apart. Which I thought I'd put... Oh, I know where it is. Whoops. It's still on the water butt at Mum's. Along with the battery casing for that drill, because the battery went on this. It just started leaking, and it's damaged one of the contacts in the drill. So I've got to sort that out. I've got a bike up for sale at the moment. I've got this one, which was my stepdad's, but I'm going to keep it. I can't bring myself to sell that one. And there's my little shopper behind it. I've just got to sort the gears out on this, and that is it. I can't remember the brand. I think it's a Royal Enfield, if I remember rightly. Everything's working. That's not the correct rear light for it, though. But I've got a... Well, I don't know if it would have been the one or the style that would have come off it, but it would have been one like this, just a little chrome one. I'm going to check the nut. Is that a Sturmey Archer? I can't see in this light if it says Sturmey Archer on it, but it certainly looks like a Sturmey Archer, and that's a Sturmey Archer, so that is a Sturmey Archer light, but it's just a little bit too new. It doesn't go with the front light. That actually goes with, see them two just down in here? Goes with them. It's what my Elswick has got on it. Good lights. They're actually bloody good lights. So that is it. And I've bought these big cardboard, I've got another three big cardboard boxes. Because I've got to try and package that record player and get that posted. So I bought several boxes home. Oh, do excuse me. That was bad. And rude. Anyway. I couldn't find any boxes big enough, so I bought several home so I could like put a couple of boxes together to package this thing up, get that out of my way. I was just checking I put the clips on round the right way. I've not done that yet. I hope I don't do that. That would prove to be a disaster if I did. Right. One thing I don't understand with eBay, I was just looking at random things on eBay, and you get the bit that says item location, you know, in the refine your search, and it's always on default. But when it's on default, you get things from around the world, particularly Hong Kong and America. Or United States, as it says on here. Yep, but that top one on this search list. And then you get a choice for within, so you can set your miles of your postcode, you know, within so many miles. Then you get UK only. Then you get the European Union, and then you get worldwide. But I don't understand why your country of origin, you know, where you are currently living, isn't automatically your default setting. I think it should be. So if you want to then look worldwide or whatever, you can then just click on one of, you know, see what's on other webs or other eBay sites around the world. Because I do prefer to purchase things from the UK, mostly just because of the postage cost. It can just be so extortionate that I do try to purchase from the UK. And it seems like America and Australia are the two most expensive countries to purchase from. Anyway, what I was actually going to come back to eBay for was to actually search for multimeter probes. So we'll type that in. Multimeter probes. You can't beat good probing. Here we go. Look at these, look. $3.59 for a set. It's probably one of the cheapest parts of the multimeter to make. This kit, look, well, I think these are for, you know, the better ones. Oh, there's some from Hong Kong. That's the style I need, although these haven't got the finger guards, so I'm not going to go for those. See, I don't know if these ones would actually fit mine. I don't think they will, to be honest. from Guernsey, 249. But again, there's no finger guard on them. There they are. These are the ones I want. Up to 1,000 volts. You knew I wouldn't trust it. Or 20 amps. Yeah, I wouldn't trust them. I think this bit is a bit longer, so they won't sit as deep in my multimeter, but that doesn't matter. But for 190, I'm going to add them to watch list. I'm going to get a couple Thursday. Because it's going to cost, well, if I get one of those multimeters in town, it's going to cost me $5.99, so for the sake of £4, at least I'll have a spare set in case one set break, because I have had pairs do that. Have a look and see. Ooh. Some already made up for crocodile with crocodile clips. I made mine. What happened? A probe fell off the end of the original probe leads that came with my new meter. So I just took the red one off and stuck crocodile clips on the end and made my own setup. Get all sorts on here, look at them all. Laser digital multimeter with temp probe, £30. If I was bigger on electronics, you know, into electronics a lot more, I would get a multimeter which is far better than that, but I'm not, so I'm not going to bother. Flame and Nora, £252 for one there. And that's exactly the fucking same, excuse my language, as the other one I just looked at. Exactly the same. Some sellers are just having a laugh, you know, they really are. Anyway, I'm going to end the video here, because this has been quite a long one. So, yeah. The Scalextric itself I'll put on Gumtree. Along with the track extension pack, I think. But that Dunlop bridge, I'm going to put on eBay. So I think once I've done this, I'm going to take a photo of these. Somewhere on the floor, I'll make some room. And get that done tonight. No doubt someone will buy them. I don't even know what to put them up for, to be honest. I've got no idea at all what they're worth. I might stick them up for £30. I don't even know if that's cheap or too much. I have no idea. I might actually just do an eBay and see roughly what they go for. Anyway, thanks a lot for watching. If you liked the video, hit the like button. If you didn't, hit the dislike button. Entirely your choice, as I always say. Can I help you? No? Alright. And subscribe if you haven't already. And thanks in advance. If you do subscribe, much appreciated, and I'll talk to you again soon. Bye.